I'm going to show you how to configure MQTT under vNode using a generic broker. In our case, the generic broker is Mosquito, and we are going to create on the one end a publisher and on the other end a writer. They both communicate with the broker using MQTT protocol. Step 1. Download Mosquito. It's free on the official website. Mosquito appears here. Then open vNode. I created two machines, one in local for the publisher and the other one distant for the writer. Let's start clicking first on config, then models, then on model, new model. Let's give a name to this new model. In our case, MQTT publisher. Then save it and select the model type. In our case, MQTT. Save the changes and don't forget to save your logger. Usually the default values are fine. Go back on MQTT Publisher. Now we are going to create a new connection. Click New Connection, give it a name. Once you save your changes, the configuration window opens. This is where you are going to configure all the settings of the MQTT connection. First, I select custom since I'm using a generic broker. Then I type MQTT for the protocol. Then I'm going to write down the local address of the broker. Then I type the client ID. In the case you use a secure connection, you have the possibility to write down username and password. It's not my case here, so I move forward. Each connection can have a last will and testament. My topic here will be last will and payload connection dropped, for example. I leave quality of service as 0. And that's it. I have created my connection. Now I'm going to create a new publisher. I select new publisher. I give it a name. The push interval is how long the publishers wait to collect data before it sends it to the broker if online. Let's set it to 60,000 milliseconds here. Write your topic. In my case, it will be sensor temperature, cost 0, and then I move on to the packet options. I'm going to leave the default values since for me they are fine. Store and forward is used to back packets to disk if the memory gets filled and they can't be sent. I'm okay with those, so I move forward to payload options. Available options for compression, known, deflate, jzip. Last step before sending a packet is encoding. I select UTF-8 because recommended for uncompressed JSON. In the process of ending with the publisher side, I have to create a tag filter. So I give it a name and then I will copy-paste the path to a tag I previously created. I save the changes. And that's it. I'm done with the publisher side. So now I have to create my writer on my second virtual machine. So if you remember well, I had to create two different ones, but in your case, it's possible that you use vNode only on one side, either publisher or writer. So you see my IP is different here. It's not in local. So how to create a writer? Well, let's do exactly the same first step as for the publisher. So config, Models, then New Model. I'm going to name it. So this time it will be MQTT Writer. I save the changes. I select the model type in the drop-down list. I save the changes. And I don't forget to save my logger. Same as previous, I'm going to create a connection on the writer side. So I give it a name. Connection Mosquito 2. I save it. I select custom, since this is a generic broker, MQTT, my broker URL, actually it will be the IP of my first machine. I write down the port name and the client ID. I save the changes and I go straight to new writer. I give it a name. I give a name to my writer, and then in my topic, I write down sensor temperature, if you remember well. Then in the payload options, I'm going to configure the data structure, compression, encoding, etc. UTF-8. Then I create a new tag filter, so I name it. Here too, I'm going to copy-paste the path of a tag previously created, which will be pressure 2. I save the changes, I accept to restart the model. And then when I go in real time, I select my tag group and I see pressure 2 writing. That's it, guys. Thanks for watching. You see only a few minutes to configure MQTT with vNode. For further information, visit vnodeautomation.com or ask your dedicated account manager. Thanks again. Bye.